the polka dot door, the polka dot door. Let's peep through the polka dot door. Songs and stories and so much more. Through the polka dot door, this is the time we always say, get ready, get set for Imagination Day. We'll tell some tales, we'll pretend and play. So come in the polka dot way.
There. That's pail number 12. That's a dozen pails of sand.
One more for good measure. That makes 13. A baker's dozen. Oh, hello. We're playing in the sandbox today.
Hi. The toys wanted a landscape. With a plain, a lake, a swamp,
some hills, and mountains. And this is the biggest and the largest mountain. It's going to be a volcano. But it needs a hole in the top. It's going to be a crater.
And coming up from way inside the center of the Earth is red-hot melted rock called lava. And the lava pushes itself up through the inside of the crater and out the top.
Well, there's the landscape for your dinosaurs' toys. Have you decided which dinosaurs you're going to put in it?
Well, Humpty has. It's the Stegosaurus. Because Humpty likes the idea that it had a brain as small as a walnut inside its huge head. Oh, Humpty.
One Stegosaurus coming up with a dangerous spiky tail.
And Humpty says that it ate plants, so it should live over by the ferns.
Okay, here comes a Stegosaurus. Over by the swamp, by the ferns, in the sun, lived the Stegosaurus with its long spiky tail. Grump, 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 it would say, and it growled and grumbled all the livelong day.
Well, there, Humpty. Now your Stegosaurus can have its fill of juicy green ferns.
What's that, Dumpty? Oh, Dumpty says that he wants a Dimetrodon because its name means it has teeth of two different sizes. The Dimetrodon was a meat eater, not a plant eater.
One Dimetrodon coming up with its fan-shaped sail of skin on its back.
What's that, Dumpty? Oh, that's right. The Dimetrodon was a cold-blooded reptile. The blood in its sail was warmed by the sun, and when the blood flowed through its body, the Dimetrodon was warm.
Well, in that case, we'll put it on a huge rock, Dumpty, so it'll be nice and sunny. Here comes Dimetrodon. Over on a hill, on a rock in the sun, lived a Dimetrodon with its fan-shaped sail. Growl, 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 it would say, and it growled and crawled all the livelong day.
Well, Dumpty, I guess your Dimetrodon won't get a chill when it's sitting on the rocks in the sun.
Marigold wants the Allosaurus because she likes its big toothy smile.
One Allosaurus coming up.
Oh, Marigold, I don't think I'd even call that a big toothy grin. The Allosaurus was a very fierce meat-eating dinosaur.
The Allosaurus was a large dinosaur, and although it was large, it could run very fast and would catch other dinosaurs and eat them.
Marigold says that it can live over by the lake and wait for the other dinosaurs to come and have a drink.
Okay, here comes the Allosaurus over to the lake for dinner. Over by the lake, in the sand, in the sun, lived the Allosaurus with its long toothy grin. Grr, 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 it would say, and it roared and rumbled all the livelong day.
Well, Marigold hopes that none of the other dinosaurs will drink from that side of the lake. So do I, Marigold.
Oh, what's that, Bear? Oh, Bear says he wants a Triceratops with its scary horns.
One Triceratops coming up with its three spiky horns. And Bear, the name means, tri means three, Sarah means horns, and ops means eyes. So, Triceratops.
What's that, Bear? Well, Bear says that the Triceratops was a plant eater, a vegetarian. Let's put it by the trees.
All right, here comes Triceratops. Over on a hill in the trees in the sun lives a Triceratops with its three spiky horns. Trish, tarish, trish, it would say, and it trished and tramped all the livelong day.
Well, Bear, I think your Triceratops is happy amongst the trees.
Well, Toys, you've showed and told us all about your favorite dinosaurs.
Yes, and where they lived. Our song of the week is all about showing and telling. Why don't you help us sing it and do the actions? Can you show me, can you tell me what the dinosaurs are doing?
They are clomping, they are clomping, and this is what they say. Growl, growl.
All the live long day.
Can you show me, can you tell me what the big trains are doing?
They are chugging, and this is what they say. Buff, buff, doot, doot.
All the live long day.
Can you show me, can you tell me what the bicycles are doing?
They are racing, and this is what they say. Bring, 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 bring.
All the live long day.
Can you show me, can you tell me what the froggies are doing?
They are hopping, and this is what they say. Ribbit, ribbit.
All the live long day.
Can you show me, can you tell me what the puppets are doing?
They are dancing, and this is what they say. Ha ha ha. Ho, ho, ho.
All the live long day.
Well, we just have a few more dinosaurs to put in our dinosaur park.
Oh, there's a story time clock, and I'm telling the time and the story today. I think I will be Tyrannosaurus Rex.
I think he should be called Dinosaurus Rex, don't you? Come on, Toys, let's hurry up and finish here, and then we can play in our dinosaur land. Now, oh, here's the Tyrannosaurus Rex. Let's see now. Put him over here. And here's the Scolosaurus. I'll put him right over here. Oh, and here's the Albertosaurus. Let's see now. I'll put him right over here.
Let's tell the time together. The long minute hand has moved 3/4 of the way around the clock, so it's 1/4 to something. And the short hour hand is pointing almost to the 12. So story time today is 1/4 to 12. Well, hello, story time mouse. I see you've got a pet dinosaur for a friend. You're taking him for a walk. Well, be careful. Don't let him step on anybody's car, or else he might squash it. If you had a pet dinosaur, what would you do with it? Perhaps you could play games on it because it was so huge. Bernard Most wrote our story for his two boys who loved anything and everything about dinosaurs. It's called If the Dinosaurs Came Back.
I like dinosaurs. I think about them all the time. I read about them. I talk about them. Oh, how I wish the dinosaurs could come back. If the dinosaurs came back, they could carry my daddy to work and back. If the dinosaurs came back, we wouldn't need any more lawnmowers. If the dinosaurs came back, house painters wouldn't need any more ladders. If the dinosaurs came back, they would scare away the robbers. If the dinosaurs came back, they would make it easy for farmers to plow their fields. If the dinosaurs came back, they could help lumberjacks chop down trees. If the dinosaurs came back, they could help firefighters put out fires. If the dinosaurs came back, they could help build big skyscrapers. If the dinosaurs came back, they would make great ski slopes. If the dinosaurs came back, they could take swimmers on rides at the beach. If the dinosaurs came back, they could rescue kites stuck in very tall trees. If the dinosaurs came back, mountain climbers would have new mountains to climb. If the dinosaurs came back, they could be a big help at the circus. If the dinosaurs came back, they could help librarians get books from the top shelf. If the dinosaurs came back, dentists would have plenty of teeth to work on. If the dinosaurs came back, giraffes would have someone to look up to. If the dinosaurs came back, they could push away rain clouds so the sun would always shine. But best of all, if the dinosaurs came back, they would make great pets for people who love dinosaurs. The end.
And that's the end of our story. Let's take a walk, and we'll meet a dinosaur. As we were walking down the street, down the street, down the street, a dinosaur we chanced to meet. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Rig-a-jig-jig and away we go, away we go, away we go. Rig-a-jig-jig and away we go. Hi-ho, hi-ho, hi-ho. Oh, phew. We got away. Well, maybe we'll meet a friendly dinosaur. Here we go. As we were walking down the street, down the street, down the street, a dinosaur we chanced to meet. Oh, hi, oh, hi, oh, hi. Rig-a-jig-jig and away we go, away we go, away we go. Rig-a-jig-jig and away we go. Hi-ho, hi-ho, hi-ho. That was a friendly dinosaur. Now let's pat it. There. It's really happy to see us, and it's wagging its big tail. Uh-oh, you better duck. Watch out for the tail. Oh, are you all right? Good. Now let's feed it a big bunch of celery.